Hey, it's Becky. Today's project is electro etching, making permanent designs in metal using a few common things you can find around the house. It could be you want to etch your own circuit boards, or in my case, I'm making brass plaques to commemorate my brother who recently passed away. I'm using a 12 volt 2 amp power supply, which I've modified by replacing the connector with longer wires. I attached a gator clip to the negative side. You'll also need a tall plastic bin. This one is marketed for storing breakfast cereal, an aquarium pump driving an aerator stone, the metal to etch, and a commensurately sized piece of scrap steel, and some warm salt water. But before etching, the artwork has to be transferred to the brass. Make sure your metal is super clean before you apply your artwork, and don't touch it with your fingers after you've cleaned it. I first tried using the toner transfer method, which is popular among those making their own printed circuit boards, but I couldn't get it to work. From what I read, there's a sweet spot in both temperature and pressure that results in success, and I just didn't get there. So even though I was trying to make this project with all simple tools, I ended up resorting to using my vinyl cutter to cut out my design, which also then necessitates a bunch of tweezer work. On the back, I taped the positive wire to the center of the area to be etched so that the wire makes good contact with the metal, and covered the entire back of the metal in more sticky vinyl. You can use tape for this, just be sure it's waterproof. Painter's tape is not. To set up my etching bath, I filled my plastic bin with warm salt water and added the aquarium aerator, which functions to keep the liquid moving and also helps separate the two electrodes, since they shouldn't touch each other. I put my brass with the positive wire attached to it in on one side of the container. I clipped the negative wire to a piece of stainless steel about the same size as my brass, then slid it in the other side of the container. I used a clamp to secure the metal to the container, mostly so that you could see better. When I plugged it in, small bubbles could be seen on both the steel and the brass, showing that the reaction is starting. I let this setup go for about 2 hours. You could speed this up by substituting vinegar for the water, but I didn't want to make a big smell. This setup can create small amounts of harmful gas anyway, though, depending on which metals you're working with, so do this in a well-ventilated area. So what's going on here? It's a type of forced corrosion. The positively charged plate excites the electrons in the copper and zinc making up the brass, and some of the atoms give up their outer shell electrons to the surface atoms, which are then called positively charged ions, and they dissolve in the liquid electrolyte, breaking off from the surface. Eventually, you can start to see the buildup of copper in the solution. You can get supplies and tools to make your own electro-etching setup at DigiKey, the sponsor for this video. Head to the link in the description for the full write-up with links to everything I used. Before removing the sticky vinyl, I applied some blackening solution to provide contrast to the lettering. Then I peeled away the vinyl to reveal the final design. The blackening solution got up under the sticker in a few places, but a quick scuff with a high grit sanding pad cleaned it up quick. I cut out the smaller plaques with my jeweler's saw and cleaned them up with my belt sander before drilling the mounting holes. Then I used rivets to attach one to the coffee can, my brother's preferred vessel. I designed the artwork in Illustrator to mimic the Café Bustelo logo. Really, I only needed to make up an R and an N, since I could just trace the rest of the letters. My brother would have loved this.